sitting live at New York, listening to Blondie.
That's right.
And talking about how 50 years ago today, the first commercial cell phone call was made. 50 years ago?
50 years ago.
I don't know. It seems long. NBC News correspondent Joe Fryer has this look back.
Long before sleek smartphones were practically welded to our hands, the technology looked like this. A brick is how some might describe it, though perhaps it's more fitting to call it a building block.
This phone, you can see how big it is. It weighed 2.5 pounds, would you believe?
Marty Cooper worked for Motorola back in 1973, overseeing the company's cell phone development division.
So is this right here where history was made?
Right here. You know, who should I call? And it occurred to me that I would call my counterpart in the Bell system.
From this exact spot, exactly 50 years ago today, Cooper made the first mobile cell call, dialing up his rival at Bell Labs.
And I said, Joel, I'm calling you on a cell phone, a real cell phone, a handheld, personal, portable cell phone. You could tell that I was not averse to rubbing it in.
So you were bragging a little bit there.
I sure was.
Scenes like this are becoming commonplace.
It would be another decade before Motorola's Dynatac phone was on the market, selling for close to $4,000. With a price tag like that, they were initially toys for the elite.
This is your wake-up call, pal.
You know, Wall Street types. Well, those early models might now be characterized as clunky. Here's how they were described on Today.
It's small, it's smart, it's even sexy.
Over the years, as the phone shrank, interest grew, which meant fewer folks were clueless.
He gave me a C minus.
Well, he gave me a C, which drags down my entire average.
Before long, the devices could be fiercely flipped.
Hello.
And eventually, their skill set expanded well beyond mere calls with the BlackBerry and, of course, the iPhone.
Most of what you do is social media, texting, talking on the phone. The future of the cell phone is much more complicated and much more bright than that.
Cooper says this is just the beginning, that this technology will revolutionize education, healthcare, and so much more, which is why when people call him the father of the cell phone, well, it has a nice ring to it.
He's great. Great character.
By the way, I miss the BlackBerry.
How about the clunky, bulky phone? So when I was working at Fox 61, Channel 61 in Hartford, mm-hmm. Connecticut, the news at 10, I used that clunker, the big
huge really?
One. Yeah, wow. And a typewriter. So wow. Definitely have come a long way, or another way of saying I'm definitely, that was like 30 years ago. And you were all using cell phones. This guy uses a flip phone
I've
now.
Gone back to the
He's
flip.
He's given up the iPhone.
No, it's just.
Goodbye.
Yeah, it's just the amount of time that
the distraction.
Devours, and the distraction, it's insanity. And I think about how successful people were with their time before smartphones
and
came along.
Brain health.
And brain, it just makes a lot more sense to have the flip phone.
Absolutely. Yeah.